गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर प्रेजेंट एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच हैव डिफरेंट वैल्यूज एंड द करंट इज नॉट डिवाइडेड इक्वली अमंग देम. सो यू कैन सी द क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. फर्स्टली दिस इज जसकीरत फ्रॉम दिस एंड एंड द कंटेंट इज कॉपीराइटेड टू मी एंड मिस्टर सुशील. सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम लेट्स स्टार्ट द इंटरेक्टिव सेशन. सो here you can see this is the 16 volt battery that is connected here. 16 volt battery that is connected here. I hope this is all visible. Positive and negative. Positive on the left side and negative on the right side. So I hope this is visible. So students, what will happen here is the positive voltage because this positive terminal is connected to this side, and here again described as positive voltage. At this right side, this terminal has some negative voltage, and this terminal has also some negative voltage. So that means due to this 16 volt battery, this diode, these two diodes, this diode and this diode, both the diodes are forward biased because positive voltage on the left hand side, that is P side, and negative voltage on the N side. So if you are not aware about the forward biasing, then you can watch my earlier lectures. So this is the latest lecture that is based on the resistances concept. So I hope now you have understood that this diode is forward biased and this diode will be also forward biased. Okay, so both the diodes are forward biased. Now raising the diagram, you can note down. Okay, the content was that this is also forward biased and this below diode is also forward biased. So that means both will act as a closed switch. So both will offer almost here forward resistance is given. Forward resistance is 0 ohm. So they will act like this one. They will act like a closed switch. They will act like a closed switch, and some current will flow I2 in this upper resistance 5 ohm and in the lower resistance 20 ohm. Students, the concept is that in this video I have taken the different resistance. Earlier, in the earlier video, both the resistances are of 20, 20, 5, 5, that means current is divided equally in the earlier video. But here you can see in this video, you will see that current will be not divided equally. So that will be a different point from the earlier video as compared to earlier video. So let's move to this diagram. This is the next diagram that is subsequently made by the okay. So I will erase this one. Some changes will be there. Now see this 5 ohm and this 20 ohm diode is offering 0. So this is 0. 0 plus 5 is 5 and 0 plus 20 is 20. So that means now 5 and 20 are in parallel. So 5 and 20 are in parallel, 1 by 5 plus 1 by 20. So I will try, I will solve the whole question here. So LCM is 20 now. This is equal to 1 by RP, where RP is the parallel combination resistance of this 5 ohm and 20 ohm. So RP, equivalent resistance of this parallel combination. So this is 20. LCM of 5 and 20 is 20. And here we got 5 4 the 20 and 20 1 the 20. So it comes out to be 5 by 20, that is equal to 1 by RP. Students, you can calculate or you can pause the video if you are interested. Otherwise you can see the solution. So RP comes out to be from this whole calculation, students, RP comes out to be 5 4 20. So RP comes out to be 4 ohm. I hope this is clear. RP comes out to be 4 ohm. This is the value of RP. RP is the parallel combination resistance of 5 ohm and 20 ohm. So these two are after combining or after resulting result of 5 and 20 is 4 ohm. I hope this is clear. You can note down the solution. I have to erase it. You can note down, please. Okay, if you have noted up to this point, now I am clearing the content. So this 5 ohm and 20 ohm is giving me 4 ohm resistance. So now I am changing little bit, diagram is changing little bit. Okay, so here is some changes. Okay, this is offering this 5 ohm and 20 ohm. Okay, that I have connected. Okay, it is. Now it is. So now can I draw a one resistance? Can I draw a one resistance instead of these two? So instead of these two, I am drawing here one resistance. That is the equivalent resistance of these two, 5 and 20. So this is the equivalent resistance. And then we have the 4 ohm. So this has value now 4 ohm. So 4 ohm is the equivalent resistance of resistance 5 and 20. So 4 plus 4 is 8. So total resistance is now 8. And the voltage is 16. The total voltage is 16. Okay. So 16 by 8. The current comes out to be 2 ampere. Students, I hope this is clear how the current comes out to be 2 ampere. Current ki value 2 ampere aayi hai mere paas. That is the total current. So 2 ampere is what this total current is that is coming from the battery is 2 ampere. Okay, now we have to find the I1 and I2. There are two methods for finding I1 and I2. I will explain the both methods. Listen to me. If I write here I and V. This method I have already told in the second unit also, that if we have the resistance ratio, here the resistance ratio is 5:20. Here the resistance ratio is 5:20. So current will ratio will be opposite to the resistance. So current ratio will be 20:5. So that voltage is equal to V is equal to IR. So this will also remain 100. This will also remain 100. This is the first method that I am saying. Because in the parallel combination, same voltage will drop across this 5 ohm. Same voltage will drop across this 20 ohm. That's why I am changing it into equal value. How can I change? 5 resistance ratio is 5:20. Current ratio will be 20:5. Current ratio is opposite to the resistance ratio. When there are two resistance, we can simply this one 5:20. Then we can simply 20:5. We can change it. Okay. So here you can see how many current parts are there. If I change it into ratio. This is 20:5, so current is in ratio 4:1 is the current ratio. 20:5 I can write it as 4:1. So how many total parts are there now? I am changing going down. Okay. How many total parts are there? Total parts of current are 5. 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 parts are equal to 2 ampere. 5 parts are equal to 2 ampere na. So what will happen? 5 parts are equal to 2 ampere. 1 part is equal to 2/5 ampere. 1 part is equal to 2/5 ampere. So that means 1 part is flowing through which resistance? Here you can see 1 part is flowing through 20 ohm resistance. 20 ohm is this one, I1. So that means the value of I1, the value of this current I1 is 2/5. I will write after this calculation. So it is 2/5. One part is flowing here and the and four parts are flowing here, so 4 into 2 by 5 are flowing through the 4 into 2 by 5, so 4 to the 8 by 5. So this is current I2, this is current I1, and I we have calculated. So three values we have calculated. What method I am following here, I will tell the other method also to you, but this method you can use, aap isko bhi use kar sakte hain, you can follow the other method also. So here 5 into resistance ratio is 5:20, so current ratio will be 20:5, so that voltage V is equal to IR becomes a constant for both, because in they are in parallel combination, and in the parallel combination the voltage drop is same. So this method is another the method that I some you can follow. You can follow the other method also. So finally if I can you can note down up to this point. Okay, now I am raising it all. Okay, that means we have calculated three values. This I1, wait for 1 minute. This the current I equal to, so firstly I have said that you have to find the current, so I equal to 2 ampere. I1 equal to 2 by 5 ampere. I1 equal to 2 by 5 ampere, and I2 is equal to 8 by 5. So now I will tell you the another method that you can use for the calculation. So approximately 15 to 16 minutes one question is taking. You can increase the YouTube video speed, you can watch it with 2x speed or 1x speed, 1.5x speed. I am speaking slowly because you can understand everything, so that you can understand everything. So I comes out to be 2 ampere, this is the total current that is like this one. Okay, this is the total current now, this is the total current. After that I1 is the current flowing through 20 ohm resistance, so this is the resistance 20 ohm, and I1 current is 2 by 5 ampere. Then third one is this one I2, I2 is equal to 5 ohm ke through 8 by 5 ampere is flowing. Now see the another method that we can use. We know we have calculated the total current. After calculating total current, we can find the voltage drop across this 4 ohm. So it will be V is equal to IR, so it will be 8 volt. V is equal to I into R, 4 into 2. So 8 volt voltage will drop here. 8 volt voltage will drop here now. How much total voltage is there? 16 volt total. So that means 8 volt is dropping across this parallel combination circuit. This parallel combination, 8 volt is dropping here. 8 volt is dropping across the 4 ohm resistance, 8 volt is dropping here. So that means we can find directly voltage is, now we know the voltage, so 8 by 5 will be the current here. This method is more easy as compared to the earlier one. 8 by 5 voltage by resistance, 8 by 5, and in case of I1 we can find 8 by 20. So students, you can follow any method that is suitable to you. So what we have calculated, if you look at the exact diagram now, if you look at carefully, firstly we have calculated three values, that is total current I, 2 ampere, I1 that is 2 by 5 ampere, that is the current flowing through 20 ohm resistance. Then 8 by 5, that is the current flowing through the 5 ohm resistance. Then we have calculated the voltage drop. If we have to find the voltage drop, then you can say voltage drop across this 4 ohm is, voltage drop across this 4 ohm. Wait for 1 minute please. Okay, so voltage drop across this 4 ohm is 8 volt. Voltage drop across this 5 ohm is 8 volt. as diode is offering zero resistance, so voltage drop across the diode is zero. Voltage drop across the diode is zero, and voltage drop across the 20 ohm resistance is also 8 volts. So 8 volts to bache common ho jayega. 8 volt will be the common voltage for 5 and 20 parallel combination. So 8 volt will drop in this circuit. 8 volt will drop in 4 ohm resistance. And the values of current we have calculated 2 ampere, 2 by 5 ampere I1 and I2, 8 by 5. So you can note down the solution from this page. Okay, now we have to move to the question number 2. You can note down the solution, please. Okay, thank you so much. And so these are the currents, and voltage drop across 5 ohm is 8 volt. Okay, 8 volt is dropping across 20 ohm resistance. This is parallel combination, so 8 volt will drop here, and 8 volt is dropping across 4 ohm resistance. So this was all about the questions, and this is the current. Okay, so these are the three values of current. I hope everything is clear to you in first question. For any doubts, my phone number is available on that on the starting of the screen. That is wait. So this is my phone number that is available on the screen, 8727955300. For any queries or any doubts, I am available here. You can drop a message. Okay. So I hope you have noted down the question. And now I am going to move to the question number 2. Okay, the question number 2 is on screen. The question number 2 is on screen. Okay. Black mark, please. Okay, without wasting any time, let's start our session. Next question. So here you can see positive supply is connected here. Students, you have to check battery also. We may connect the terminals in this way, negative here or positive here. So that you have to also see. So this is positive, this is negative, this is positive, and this is negative. So that means in this case also both the diodes are forward bias. I have taken the resistance different values so that you can understand the question easily. So I hope it is clear up to this point. Up to this point, both the diodes are forward biased. So here, if I draw this one, this is again forward biased, and this is again forward biased. And forward resistance in this case is not written. You have to take it as zero. You have to take the forward resistance as zero. Okay. So I hope it is clear. Now see, this 10 and this 40. It will be 1 by 10 plus 1 by 40 because it is a parallel combination. So 1 by 10 plus 1 by 40. So this is equal to LCM is 40, and in the numerator you will get 10 fourth of 40 and 40 ones the 40. So 4 plus 1 will be there. So it comes out to be the parallel combination of 10 and 40 is giving me the resistance that is equal to, that is giving me a resistance that has a value equal to 8 ohm. So 8 ohm value I am getting from this combination, that is 10 ohm and 40 ohm. So from these two I am getting one resistance that is of 8 ohm. Now I am clearing it, you can note down. You can note down, please. You can note down. Okay, so now without any wasting time, you can see this is the forward bias. So if I raise it, wait. Okay, so if I raise this one, and if I raise this one, I am left with the how much resistance? I am left with the okay, this is the resistance now. This resistance has the value how much value is it has? It has the value of 8 ohm. Now pay the attention, this suppose current is flowing from here, then this current will be not divided, this current will be same through this 8 ohm. That means now this 8 ohm and this 8 ohm are in series. So 8 plus 8 is 16. So 16 is the total resistance. 16 is the battery voltage. That means total current that is coming from the battery, that is equal to 1 ampere. Students, I hope this is clear. 1 ampere is the total current that is coming from the battery. 1 ampere is the total current that is coming from the battery. So what I have to do now, I have to find the other current. Current flowing through 10 ohm resistance, current flowing through 40 ohm resistance. So now I am taking the second method, that is voltage method. I am not using ratio method because sometimes the ratio method seems complex. So here you can find the voltage drop across 8 ohm. Voltage drop will be equal to V is equal to I into R, so it will be 8 volt. So that means 8 volt is dropped here. What is left? 16 volt total, 8 volt is dropped here. So that means across this parallel combination, 8 volt voltage is dropping. 8 volt in the upper resistance, 8 volt in the lower resistance. So if I clear it, you can find, if I mark, this is the total current I. Okay, if I mark here I, this is, let's suppose I1. Okay, this is first current is I1, current flowing through 40 ohm, and the current flowing through 10 ohm is I2. I hope this content is visible to you, and if you like this video, you are feeling it useful, then you can share with your friends. Okay, so total current we have calculated, that is equal to 1 ampere. Okay, I1 is that current that is flowing through 40 ohm. So 40 ohm, across the 40 ohm, how much voltage is dropping? Voltage dropping is 8 volt. So it will be 8 by 40. 8 by 40. So 1 by 5 current is flowing through the 40 ohm resistance. So 1 by 5 ampere. 1 by 5 ampere current is flowing through the 40 ohm resistance, this resistance. That current has value I1. I1 is equal to 8 by 40, that is equal to 1 by 5 ampere. You can follow the ratio method also. That is also the same thing. Then we have to find the I2 is the current that is flowing through the 10 ohm resistance. So it has the value 8 by 10. That is equal to 8 by 10. That is equal to 4 by 5 ampere. Students, up to this point the question is we have calculated the current for every resistance. So now I am repeating the concept. Okay, what we have calculated? Firstly, we have calculated the total current, that is I, that is equal to 16 by 16, that is equal to 1 ampere. Okay, up to this point clear. After that, we have calculated the voltage drop across 8 ohm resistance, that is equal to 8 volt. 8 volt is dropping here, that means rest of the voltage is dropping across the other resistances. So 8 volt is dropping here, and I1 we have equal to 8 by 40, that is equal to 1 by 5 ampere. I2 equal to 8 by 10, that is equal to 4 by 5 ampere. So if you add I1 and I2, you will get the total current. I1 plus I2 is equal to I. So this is satisfying. 4 by 5 plus 1 by 5 is equal to 5 by 5, that is equal to 1 ampere. So यहाँ तक क्वेश्चन में कहीं गड़बड़ हो चाहे सब, यू कैन आस्क इफ एनी डाउट यू हैव. वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड द थ्री वैल्यूज ऑफ करंट, दैट इज इक्वल टू 1 एम्पियर करंट, 1 by 5 एम्पियर करंट एंड 4 by 5 एम्पियर करंट. थ्री करंट्स वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड इन दिस क्वेश्चन. And we have calculated the voltage drop across 8 ohm and voltage drop across this one, voltage one. So firstly, you can note down the current. The currents are 1 ampere is the total current. I am repeating again, 1 ampere is the total current. 1 by 5 ampere is the current I1, that is the current flowing through 40 ohm resistance. I1 is the current that is flowing through the 40 ohm resistance. And I2 is the current that is flowing through 10 ohm resistance, that has value 4 by 5 ampere. This is the value of I2. and this is the value of I1. You can note down these. And if I have to find the voltage drop, I have already said that voltage drop across 8 ohm resistance is 8:1, so it is 8 volt. And in this parallel combination, we cannot use V is equal to I into R. If you have calculated the I, then you can use. Otherwise, you can simply write that 16 volt is total voltage, 8 volt is used, so 8 volt will drop across this 40 ohm resistance as the diode is offering 0 resistance. And in this case also the voltage drop will be 8, because in the parallel combination the voltage drop is same. So 8 volt, and rest of the question we have done, and if you have any doubt then you can ask. Okay, so I will take you to the question. In the beginning the question was ki question kya tha. Okay, so this was the question in the beginning. This was the question. And we 10 and I am repeating the concept again. 10 and 40 is giving me a resistance that has value 8. That 8 is in series with this 8. So 8 plus 8 is 16. So 16 by 16 is the total current. That is equal to 16 by 16 is equal to 1 ampere. So total current that is coming from the battery is 1 ampere. What we have done next? We have calculated the voltage drop across this 8 ohm. V is equal to IR. So 8 volt is dropping here. Resistance is 8, current is 1. Because here the total current is flowing. In this resistance, in this series resistance with the battery, total current is flowing here. So that's why we can use V is equal to I into R here. But we then we have calculated here how much voltage will drop here. So rest of the voltage of battery, that is 8 volt, that will drop across this resistance and this resistance. In the parallel circuit the voltage is same. So then we have calculated the current flowing through 10 ohm resistance. Okay, so 10 ohm we have written that I2 equal to 8/10, that is equal to 4/5 ampere, and I1 equal to 8/40, that is equal to 1/5 ampere. So these are the answers that we have to find in this question. I hope the question is clear to you. If you have any doubts, then you can ask me personally on my personal number that is available in the starting of the video. So I hope second question is clear to all, and now we are moving to the question number 3. So question number 3 is on screen, and little bit similar concept can be there. Okay, so here you can see this is positive, this is negative, and this is again positive, and this is again negative. So that means the diodes are, both the diodes are forward bias again. So this is the another question in which both the diodes are forward bias. This is forward bias, so it will act as a closed switch. This will also act as a closed switch, and forward resistance is given here. Forward resistance is 0 ohm. So students, what you have to do here, you have to firstly see this 80 and 20 are in parallel combination. So I have to find the equivalent resistance of this parallel combination. So 1/80 plus 1/20 will be the equivalent resistance. 1/80 plus 1/20 will be the equivalent resistance. So if I take the LCM, this will be 80, and in the numerator term I will get 81 is the 81 plus 4, so it will become 1/16. So I have to take the reciprocal of it also. So in short, if you know about the parallel combination circuit concept, then you can simply say this 80 ohm and 20 ohm is giving me a resistance of 16 ohm. So this 80 ohm and this 20 ohm are in parallel, and they are giving me the resistance of 16 ohm. I hope it is clear. So 16 ohm is the resistance that we got from this combination. I am raising this now. Wait. So can I draw here a one circuit that has value? Okay, clear. That has the value of 16. So can I write here? Okay. So I am raising this one, and we can, that's why I have drawn two diagrams that we can take the values from that one, right one. Okay, so this is the resistance, this is the resistance, and then we have the 4 ohm. So 16 ohm is here. 16 ohm resistance is the equivalent of 80 and 20. So now 16 and plus 16 and 4. 16 plus 4 is 20, and battery is 16. So total current is equal to 16 by 20. Students, total current is equal to 16 by 20. 16 is the total voltage, 16 by 20 is the total current. I hope it is clear. 16 by 20 is the total current. 16 by 20 is the total current. Now see what we can do here. We can find the voltage drop across this 4 ohm so that we can find the current through 80 ohm and 20. So across the 4 ohm resistance, the voltage drop is 16 by 20 into 4. So this is equal to, I think, 16 by 5. Yes, so 16 by 5 is the voltage drop that is dropping here. 16 by 5. 16 by 5 volt is dropping there. And what is left? The left voltage is, okay, wait. The voltage that is left is 16 minus 16 is the total now. So 16 minus 16 by 5. 16 minus 16 by 5, that is dropping across the other resistance. So 16 5 is the 80, 80 minus 16 64. So 64 by 5 volt. This is the voltage that is dropping across the rest of the circuit. So 64 by 5 volt. So now see the diagram. Third question. Through this 4 ohm, the voltage drop is 16 by 5 volt is the voltage that is dropping across this 4 ohm resistance. And through the rest of this parallel circuit, the voltage drop is 64. Here I am writing the value. The voltage drop is 64 by 5. So now I have the voltage 64 by 5, I know, through the 80 ohm. So what I can do here, I can find the value of I1 and I2. So for the I, okay, let me see the value of I1. I1 is the current through 20 ohm. So I1 is the current that is through the 20 ohm. Okay, so 20 ohm I am writing here. 20 ohm. So voltage drop is 64 by 5. So 64 by 5. नीचे क्या आ जाएगा, V I is equal to V by R. So R is 20 here. So here you can find the total current is 64 by 100. Sorry, I1 current is 64 by 100. 5 into 20, 100. So this is the current I1 that we have calculated. I1 is the current that is flowing through the 20 ohm resistance. I hope this is clear. Students, you can note down the solution, please. You can note down the solution. So 64 by 100 is the answer for current flowing through the 20 ohm resistance. Students, you can see here, through the 20 ohm the voltage drop is 64 by 5. So voltage by current resistance, I is equal to V by R. So 64 by 5 into 20, so that is equal to 64 by 100. So 64 by 100 is the current that is flowing through. So I hope this is clear. Then students, we have calculated, we have to find the current through 80 ohm. So current through the 80 ohm will be equal to, I2 equal to 64 by 5, that is the voltage drop. 64 by 5 into 80 into 80. So 64 by 85 the 400 84 okay 400. So this is the value of I2. 64 by 100 is the value of I1, 64 by 400 is the value of I2. Students, you can add them. If you will add them, then you will get the answer as 16 by 20. So you can get the answer as 16 by 20 after the calculation, okay? So after the calculation, 16 by 20, that is the total grant. The total grant is 16 by 20, so you can add them I1 and I2 and check the answer. So let me check here, hum hi check kar lete hain yahi pe. Okay, so black. So see, let's take 64 common and rest of the term is 1 by 100 plus 1 by 400. 1 by 100 plus 1 by 400, so it is equal to 64 into 5 by 400. So after cancellation, this comes out to be 80. 64 by 80, that is equal to 16 by 20. 16 4 the 64 and 20 4 the 80, 16 by 20 is the answer. You can find calculate it in other also, but we have calculated with the 16 by 20. You can cancel out it, but we have calculated with the 60 by 20. So humne usse aage cancel nahi tha kiya, so that I have proved that the current I1 plus I2 is equal to 16 by 20. So three questions we have seen in this video. Students, the concept is that whenever there are unequal resistance, how to find the current through that resistances? Because if suppose a question is there like this one, this is the diode and this is the resistance 40, and diode is offering zero resistance, and this is the another resistance, this is the another diode, and this is the another resistance that is of 40. These type of questions I have discussed in the earlier video. Because if the total current is coming from here, total current of 2 ampere is coming from this point, then 1 ampere will go in this branch, 1 ampere will go in this branch. But when these resistances are changed, when this resistance has some value like 10 or 15 ohm then or 20 ohm, then the current is not divided equally. The current will be divided unequally. So three questions I have discussed in the video that are on the basis of unequal distribution of current. If you have any doubts or any feedback you want to provide, then you can provide to my number. This question we have discussed. We have discussed the second question. And we have discussed the first question. Okay, so first question we have also discussed. Okay, so if you have any doubts or any queries from you, then you can ask me on this number. This is my number, that is 8727955300. Okay, so if you have any doubts or any queries, you can drop a message to this number. And the content is copyright to Mr. Jaskirat and Mr. Sushil. So thank you so much, sir, for helping me and guiding me how to motivate the student and how to elaborate the my knowledge. Okay, so thank you so much, sir, and have a nice day to all the students. And please like and share this channel if you have not liked and shared up to this point. Then share the every video with your friends who are studying in plus 2 or in plus 1. So thank you so much, students. Have a nice day ahead and stay home, stay happy, stay connected. Okay, so thank you so much. Bye bye.